Hello everyone, I am Vijay Kevlani, Assistant Professor of Pharmacology, LJ Institute of Pharmacy. Welcome to the MOOC session series, an initiative taken by LJ Institute of Pharmacy. In today's session, we are going to talk about coagulants and anticoagulants. So, very first is, what is hemostasis? So, it is stoppage of bleeding from vessel at the site of injury. There are mainly three steps in hemostasis. Very first is initially vasospasm of small capillaries. Which capillaries are injured? There will be a contraction of that capillary. Second is formation of platelet plug, and third is blood clotting. Now these are the steps. Next is mechanism of blood coagulation. That is third step. Blood clotting, or you call it blood coagulation. So what is basic mechanism? So there are mainly three steps. Very first is activation of intrinsic or extrinsic pathway, which will lead to activation of factor number 10. Second is conversion of thrombin to thrombin formation, and third is fibrin formation, right? Now let's talk about coagulation. So it is complex process of enzymatic reactions in which clotting factors activates and other clotting factors in a fixed sequence until a clot is formed. So one clotting factor will activate another will activate furthermore. This is how the series is going on until the clot is formed. So disorders of coagulation can lead to an increased risk of bleeding or clotting. Now coagulants, the drugs are vitamin K in form of K1 and K3. K1 is obtained from plant, which is fat soluble, and it is known as phylloquinone. K3, which is synthetic form of vitamin K, and it is available in fat soluble and in water soluble form. Other than vitamin K, there are also other coagulants, which are fibrinogen, anti-hemophilic factor, desmopressin, adrenochrome, and rutin and ethambutolate, right? Now talking about vitamin K, so vitamin K is a fat soluble dietary principle required for the synthesis of clotting factor. The dietary requirement of vitamin K, which is produced by colonic bacteria. So vitamin K is ultimately, the point is, it is produced by colonic bacteria, and hence the daily dietary requirement will change. So we cannot specify a specific limit. We cannot give a specific limit for this. Generally, if we want to say, so it could be 3 to 10 microgram per day, external source may be sufficient. The total requirement of vitamin K for an adult has been estimated to be 50 to 100 microgram per day. It may vary. It is not necessary. Right now, how vitamin K acts as coagulant, right? How it helps in clotting the blood. So what is role of vitamin K? So vitamin K acts as a cofactor at the late stage in the synthesis by liver of coagulation proteins. So liver synthesizes this coagulation proteins, and for this synthesis vitamin K is required. We can see here in image which proteins are involved or which coagulation factors require vitamin K. So that is prothrombin, factor number 7, 9 and 10. So how? So ultimately vitamin K hydroquinone form is converted to vitamin K epoxide form in presence of carboxylase. Now due to this conversion, decarboxylate, prothrombin or vitamin 7, 9 or 10 are converted to active prothrombin or 7, 9 and 10. Right, so this is basic action of vitamin K. This is how vitamin K is acting as a coagulant. Now deficiency of vitamin K, why deficiency will occur? It could be due to liver disease like obstructive jaundice. It could be due to malabsorption, long-term antimicrobial therapy which alter the intestinal flora, and a deficient diet, and lowering of the levels of prothrombin and other clotting factors. Therapeutic use of vitamin K is 5 to 10 mg per day orally or parenterally. Newborn vitamin K IM routine 1 mg. Deficiency due to chronic use of antibiotics and antidote to oral anticoagulant, osteoporosis adjuvant. Coagulants, other are plasma fractions. So deficiency in plasma coagulation factor can cause bleeding. फैक्टर नंबर 7 डिफिशियंसी एंड फैक्टर नंबर 9 डिफिशियंसी अकाउंट फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ द हेरिटेबल कोएगुलेशन डिफेक्ट्स. कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड प्लाज्मा फ्रैक्शंस एंड रिकॉम्बिनेंट प्रोटीन प्रिपरेशंस आर अवेलेबल फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ दिस डिफिशियंसीज. डेस्मोप्रेसिन एसिटेट. सो डेस्मोप्रेसिन स्टिम्युलेट्स द रिलीज ऑफ वॉन विलबर्डन फैक्टर फ्रॉम द वाइबल पैलेट बॉडीज ऑफ एंडोथेलियल सेल्स, thereby increasing the level of von Willebrand factor 3 to 5 folds. It also used to promote the release of von Willebrand factor in patients with coagulation disorders such as von Willebrand disease, mild hemophilia A and thrombocytopenia. Cryoprecipitate. So cryoprecipitate is a plasma protein fraction obtained from whole blood. It is used to treat deficiencies or qualitative abnormalities of fibrinogen. It may also be used for patients with factor 8 deficiency and von Willebrand disease. Then after, this was all about coagulants which are used for ultimately coagulation of blood. Among them, vitamin K is very must and very widely used. Second point is local hemostatic statiptics. So these are the drugs which are used to control bleeding from local or approachable sites. The sites are tooth extraction or abrasion or nasal bleeding. So from this, ultimately, whenever their blood will come out, ultimately, that can be stopped by statiptics. Example of these drugs are thrombin, fibrin sealant, gelatin form, oxidized cellulose strip, 0.1% epinephrine soaked in sterile cotton gauze, 1% tannic acid, and ice. Now talking about anticoagulants, so drugs which help to prevent clotting of blood are known as anticoagulants. It will prevent formation of new clots or an existing clot from enlarging, but they don't dissolve already formed blood clots. So anticoagulants are not used to dissolve the blood clots, but they are as a part of preventive therapy. They are used to prevent the clot, right? Natural anticoagulants are prostacycline, antithrombin, heparin sulfate, and protein C. The used in vivo anticoagulants. So parenteral anticoagulants are indirect thrombin inhibitors. The examples are heparin, low molecular weight heparin, fondaparinux, and danaparoid. Direct thrombin inhibitors are lapirudine, bivalirudine, and ergatroban. Then after oral anticoagulants, so cumarin derivatives are there. In that, there is warfarin sodium, acinocumarol, ethyl biscuma acetate. Another is endodione derivatives, that is phenindione. Then after direct factor number 10 inhibitors, there is rivaroxaban, and oral direct thrombin inhibitor is dabigatran. In vitro anticoagulants are heparin, calcium complexing agent, that is sodium citrate, sodium oxalate, and sodium edetate. These are used as in vitro anticoagulant used in tube to prevent blood coagulation. When will blood come out from the body, it will ultimately from clot. To prevent that, these chemicals are used. Now talking about heparin, so McLean, a medical student, discovered that liver contains a powerful anticoagulant, and Howell and Holt named it heparin as it is obtained from liver. It is mixture of a mucopolysaccharide with molecular weight of 10,000 to 20,000. It contains D-glucosamine, L-iduronic acid, and D-glucosamine, D-glucuronic acid. It carries strong electronegative charge and is strongest organic acid present in the body. It is found in the secretory granules of mast cell. It is richest source are lungs, liver, and intestinal mucosa. Commercially produced from ox lung and pig intestinal mucosa, heparin produces its anticoagulant effect by activating plasma antithrombin 3 and inhibiting factor 2 and 10. Other action of heparin are antiplatelet and lipemia clearing. So antiplatelet actions are higher doses inhibits platelet aggregation, prolongs bleeding time, and it also produces thrombocytopenia. Lipemia clearing action are injection of heparin clears turbid postprandial lipemia by releasing a lipoprotein lipase from the vessel wall. Antagonist of heparin. So whenever excessive heparin is taken, the antagonist is protamine sulfate. It is strongly basic low molecular weight protein obtained from the sperm of certain feces. Weight basis, it is given in dose of IV 1 mg is needed for every 100 unit of heparin. In the absence of heparin, protamine itself act as weak anticoagulant. Pharmacokinetic of heparin. So it is large highly ionized molecule, therefore not absorbed orally. IV administration is done, IV and SC, subcutaneous administration is done. Does not cross blood-brain barrier or placenta. Safe in pregnancy. It is metabolized in liver by heparinase. Fragments are excreted in urine. Low molecular weight heparin. So it is commercially prepared by fractionation. Advantages of low molecular weight heparin are uniform absorption, long duration of action, less antigenic, less interaction with platelet, less risk of thrombocytopenia. Examples are enoxaparin, deltaparin, tinzaparin, perendaparin, and rivaparin. Oral anticoagulants. So these were parenteral anticoagulants. Now talking about oral anticoagulants. So oral anticoagulants are given by oral route. These are teratogenic. More drug interactions are seen with oral anticoagulants, and the example is warfarin sodium. Apart from that, dicumeril is also there, acinocumeril and ferindiol are oral anticoagulants. Talking about warfarin, so warfarin is a synthetic derivative of cumarin. The mechanism of warfarin is it inhibits vitamin K dependent synthesis of active forms of the clotting factor 2, 7, 9 and 10. Monitoring of prothrombin time is required. Highly protein bound, the drug is highly protein bound, and drug-drug interaction of warfarin, so which are too much important, drug-drug interaction of warfarin. So drugs which increase effect of warfarin are by enzyme inhibitors, disulfiram, allopurinol and cimetidine. So if warfarin is taken with these three drugs, ultimately the amount of warfarin will increase in body and that will lead to toxicity. Displacement from the protein binding site, that is phenytoin and probenecid, that will displace this warfarin. As warfarin is highly protein bound, it will be displaced by phenytoin and probenecid, and that is by the plasma of volume of that drug will increase and toxicity will occur. Liquid paraffin also increases excretion of vitamin K, and long-term antibiotic decreases vitamin K synthesis. So by that also warfarin values are changed. The drug-drug interaction which lead to decreased effect of warfarin, so enzyme inducers, hereditary resistance, cholestyramine, sucralfate will decrease absorption. Adverse effect of anticoagulants are bleeding, alopecia, hypersensitivity, teratogenicity, heart defects, growth retardation, warfarin poisoning. The treatment of warfarin poisoning is fresh blood transfusion, which contains clotting factors, and vitamin K specific antidote can be given, but it does not act immediately. It takes 6 to 24 hours for clotting factor to be resynthesized. Therapeutic use of anticoagulants are prophylaxis of deep vein thrombosis and pulmonary embolism. In bedridden patients and those undergoing knee hip replacement surgeries. Second is myocardial infarction. Third is unstable angina. Fourth is rheumatic heart disease. And fifth is during bypass surgery and vascular surgery, anticoagulants are given. FAQs. References. Thank you. Please like, share and subscribe our channel Pharma Ignite for more updates. Thank you.